Hello and welcome to me recording this at midnight, right at the day where I'm going to upload that video because I forgot to record it any time earlier. But anyway, now we're here, so let's go ahead. I decided, as you can see, to, well, make a small little piece of fan art for Black Friday. It just kind of put a group scene in my head and I decided, why not try to draw all these characters that I haven't fully drawn before and have only drawn simplified versions of until now. Well, that was an exciting little journey of a lot of returning to Google to look at how the heck they actually look like and what they are wearing. I think I had nightmares about Plate because I hate drawing that, but there were quite a few characters who were wearing Plate, so gotta get that done. And well, I did. So I decided to kind of make a bit of a voiceover for the sketch. Well, not the sketch, for this whole speed paint. Although I haven't really planned on what to say, so this could go either way. I could just be quiet or talk a lot of weird little things. But yeah, now that we're in the line art phase, in the sketch phase I only kind of did the roughs of what I remembered the characters wearing and looking like. Sometimes not even that, because I forgot how, I don't know, the hair worked. For example, with Tom, I had no idea how Dylan styled his hair, and I was like, what is going on there? I have no idea. So you're gonna see me quite a few times return to Google and look at people, because I forgot to set OBS to just record Clip Studio, so yeah. I also decided to go with a bit of a different style for this one. Oh yeah, spoiler alert, I gave up drawing that gun because, no, it just didn't look like how I wanted, so I went with no gun, open hand. But yeah, I decided to go with a bit of a more textured art style, at least for the line art, and later on I toned down the colors a bit. I just really enjoyed experimenting with that pen lately, with my own, you know, drawings of my OCs and all that stuff, and just playing around with that and the settings of colors and the balance between them and stuff. I didn't do any color experimentation in this one because, well, the main color is gonna be green due to a certain little Cthulhu-like entity, and that would probably kind of be weird if I just, I don't know, made that purple just for fun. Oh yeah, that happened. It was all fine. Then my PC had a little meltdown and OBS went, no, I actually don't want to. I don't want to show that. So yeah, the rest of the characters got finished and no one has any idea how that happened. Also, I apologize if there are any kind of grainy effects in between. I have no idea how they happened. They aren't when I edit the video. They also aren't when I watch the video when I'm editing it, but they exist when I save it, so they don't appear a lot, but it's still kind of annoying. At least it's bothering me. Meanwhile, I still haven't learned how to draw Wiggly from memory, and I probably never will, because I know he's such a weird shape. Like, he's so simple, but yet it's so very awkward. I don't know. I did, however, learn how to draw hands holding apples by now, due to Wilbur, Wiley, whatever you want to call them. I honestly, who knows? I mean, we all know at this point probably, but who knows, right? But we're almost done with the line art. I don't know what I did after that. Yeah. This is also a rare occasion where I did both a thumbnail, then a sketch, and then did some less basic colors for the sketch and more colors to differentiate between the different layers of the drawing, like foreground, middle, background, and characters and that. Here, my Plate nightmares begin. and they are not going to end. I absolutely despise what Tim is wearing, and I completely gave up on that, so you're gonna see me just smoosh a lot of black and lowering the opacity and smoosh more black on. Yeah, this is gonna be a bit... This was just very fast because it's just coloring eyes, coloring this, coloring that. It's just putting on colors. It doesn't take a lot. It doesn't take long. It also doesn't take a lot of brain power, so I was able to do that at night time. Like with the liner, that also didn't take a lot of brain power. I did, however, completely forget the snippets, so I very, very quickly added them in. Some adjusting here and there. And we are getting to shading. I actually took my time with shading this time around because I did want to have it a bit more detailed and less doodly, I guess. But I'm quite happy with how it turned out. I don't know, it's not my best, it's not the worst. I didn't really need something super complicated since there's gonna be a lot of just effects, I guess, like light effects and then shade effects and everything, but it was kind of therapeutic just doing that, especially with Hannah's hair. It was very nice to shade. I think it's just because I already did so well with the line art there for the shading, then it worked very nicely. Meanwhile, with other hair, I left it a bit more loose line art wise and didn't really do a lot of lines, and so I just went, I don't know what to put there or here or anywhere, because with this style I usually rely on the liner to kind of guide me in certain areas, and without it it looks very awkward, at least to me. But I'm still quite happy with how it turned out. And it's just me having to look through all the layers to know what I put on which layer, because I'm not about to make about 500 layers for each individual piece of clothing. But I also am not going to just put them all together and have to fight that little wall there. So I just put a lot on a certain layer and then a lot on another and on another. It's never was quite a lot of layers then. I usually don't use a lot of layers because they're just bothering me and I have no idea where anything is. Which is quite contradictory because I do animatics and I always do them in like one file, so every, I don't know, part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Made in America, you see it's all done in like one file. Not all of them at once, but like each video is done in one file and there's usually a lot of layers there. And I usually have to break that up if I do like multiple vines at once, so I just have like my sketch layer saved in one. Then I make a new file to actually line over it and just delete the sketches underneath so my PC doesn't have a freak out and just die on me, because that'd be quite annoying. And I really don't want that. Oh, by the way, while we're done with the eyes, hair and eyes, two of my favorite things to draw at any given time. Clothes very much depend, but I don't usually put as much time in there because I like them less complicated, I guess. But I really enjoy just drawing the hair and eyes and putting like all these nice effects on it with the light and everything. It's just very nice to do. I could do that all day. Soon drawings of people from me will just be hair and eyes, nothing else. Everything else is gonna be white, whatever, or black, or whatever the background color is gonna be. Maybe it's gonna be hot pink. Imagine that. Why not? You can watch me struggle to actually shade when the light is coming from behind and from the sides, because I haven't done that in ages. Like, just normal, I guess, pillow shading from above is fine, that's easy, that's so my comfort zone. And then I just said, you know what, I'm gonna actually have some physics happen there. Like, kind of make it have sense. But yeah, now we're done. I kind of added a bit of light afterwards, but that's all. If you wanna go look at the piece by itself, link is in the description, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. See you later. Bye bye.